not the first time I'm talking on DevConf, and last time it was a really large room, and now we have a smaller, familiar room, but I think it's quite fit for this topic. The former BOF was about the technical thing, how you can become Debian maintained or so, and I would like to talk about my ideas, how we can people more self-confident to join us and to stay in touch with us and what we are doing in the team I'm mostly based on, which is the Debian Mate team, to get more people. First, I would like to say something about the motivation. What are the teams inside? And then I have three methods, which is, one is called Mentoring of the Month, one is Sponsoring of Blends, and the third one is that we are doing sprints, which means in-person meetings once per year. So, in general, in Debian, we have two types of people, with some mix in between. You find very strong teams. I will show you some proofs why I think they are strong. And we have some lone fighters who are absolutely convinced that only this person can solve the problem and nobody else. And in most cases, to my observation, the results are better if they are the packages are team maintained, but there is a good chance that the team suddenly vanish. So a team might consist of two or three persons. One gets a new child, one gets a new job, and both have valid reason to stop their work on Debian, and then the packages are not maintained anymore without notice. So the point is we need to reach some critical mass that this sudden vanish is not possible anymore. And for me it's kind of a judgment call. Should I write the code myself, like the lonely fighter? Or should I train a newcomer, which is usually takes longer time to train the newcomer? I've done a job in 5 minutes, but it takes me maybe half an hour to explain how it's done. And so I need to make sure that this spend of time of half an hour is in the long run more efficient as if I would do it myself. It's very important to keep enthusiastic newcomers. And I try to explain how we can do this. In my opinion, it's very important that we get newcomers, because otherwise the project will somehow die. I don't think that Debian will die, but some subgroups inside Debian might die. And so, please, everybody, preserve some of your work time to train newcomers for the future. We, in general, in Debian, we have a problem, because if in a paid job, you can say, if you don't do your job, the salary is dropped. We don't have any salary, so we have a problem to attract people who remain in Debian. They have no idea anymore, or no interest anymore, then they could leave. And they could leave without any notice. People tell you that I'm not a child or so, but which is the best reason to leave, definitely. But it's happening sometimes without notice. And we also have people who write their finger, I would like to do something, I would like to be part of a team, but we do not really know, are they doing something? Are they just silent? Are they working or not? So what we are seeking is some compensation for this motivation which is given it by paid work, which we don't have. In my opinion, we could do it in three ways. We could make our project more attractive by some attractive technique. Debian has a lot of very attractive technique, which is quite sophisticated. By attractive results, if you see, well, there is some system evolving which I can really use, and some attractive work environment by friendly people supporting each other and providing help wherever it is possible. So, what do I think is an inviting environment. As I said, I'm frequently doing talks in different conferences, and I was frequently told that it's really hard to get involved in Debian, that you don't get good help. But that's not the whole truth. In part times it is true. But if you find a team which fits your needs, as I said, I'm from the Debian Med team, so if you are a biologist or if you are involved in medicine, you find help in our team. So if I write to everybody who's writing his finger in our mailing list, he gets clearly close to immediate response. And I think this responsiveness is quite important. So I have found my personal definition of what I think it's a team. And it's, for me, it's waking up in the morning and realize that somebody else has solved your problem from yesterday. And well, you think it's quite of idealistic, but I experience this. It's Olivier who is the other man here. And you see, I had a problem, it's Saturday night at after midnight. And before I was waking up, I got on Sunday, or it is Sunday, sorry. I will look for this. And then I got progress, more progress, and then we did needed to discuss something. Well, finally, on Monday, the problem was solved and uploaded. I had basically nothing done except some discussion. And say, yes, nice that you are doing it. So this is kind of a support which is volunteer-driven and way more efficient than a commercial service. I think if you want to call the service line at this time, nobody will hang up. So after the weekend, you start maybe on Monday at 10 or so, but we solve the problem 4 hours later before you have picked up even your phone or whatever. So this is what I call support, and this is what I call a team. And this team was basically built because we formally created this Debian Med project. I later present you a list that people confirmed that they are only in Debian because this Debian Med project exists, and Olivier came to us in a sprint. In an in-person meeting, you will see it later. Here's an example of what I consider a good team. This graph shows the following. This is the number of version control commits inside packages. That means a package which is only maintained by one person and not more person provide any commits. It's very low. Then you have a lot of packages which is maintained by at least two persons, and the majority of packages have at least three committers. So you don't find a single person. I have counter examples. The graph is done in the so-called team matrix effort, which I was starting in the Google Summer of Code. And this is counting the commits per package. And I did ignore something if a package has only less than five commits. So I think it's started, it's not relevant for our statistics, or it's not maintained. Or if a package has less than maintainer has less than two commits, a single commit, this could be a non-maintainer upload or something like this. It's also not relevant for the team. So I even stripped some data from this graph to make it more realistic. In the Debian Med team, we are not that good, but I think it's quite okay that the majority of packages is maintained by more than one person. I would like to get this bar down to here, but we are working on this. You are invited to do more commits on our packages. Everything is free, you can do it. And then we have the one maintainer teams. This is actually not really a team, right? You have one maintainer which is super busy, which does a very good job, but he is more or less this lone fighter, and this is the OpenStack team. I know this person, he is great, he is very helpful, but he has not or he puts not enough effort into getting new people involved. This is what I want to change. So how could you make your team more attractive? The first thing is write good documentation. I'm in the lucky position that somebody else wrote the documentation for our team. I didn't need to do it, and he did it perfect. He did it by deriving from the documentation from the Perl team. So we are using the resources inside Debian by looking what other teams are doing. And the Perl team was a very good team in the beginning. Then you should write good documentation.
What do you mean by that?
Documentation is how the team works, where is the version control system, what are the mailing lists, what workflow is used. It is called team policy. If you Google for Perl team policy, you find an example of good documentation. And in my opinion, it is important to not let potential newcomers wait longer than 24 hours. I try to be better than 8 hours. So if somebody writes on the mailing list, this is an important step, because newcomers usually are shy and reading the mailing list and don't write anything. So, and if somebody writes to the mailing list, I answer fast. If I only answer, I'm sorry, you get a detailed answer later, we are busy with something, but not responding is one of the biggest failures I think we can do or if we want to get rid of the newcomers, then we should not respond. This is the method. And you should be patient, because every newcomer might be different. Patient in the sense of, we had one newcomer who had some very leaf package of medical imaging, and I'm not a medical person, I cannot really evaluate it, but it sounded to me like if you wouldn't have this, it would be not a common thing. But I think, okay, this person is working on it, it's technically okay, so let's sponsor it. And then recently it happened that a lot of medical imaging packages had release critical bugs, and we had really problem. And then this person who made the leaf package was in need of these packages, and he fixed it. So this newcomer, which did something which was not a great thing, finally did really good things for the team. So in so far, patience for 2 years or so, where you have not seen a lot of contributions, turned out later as really worthwhile thing. And what I'm doing is, I insist in open discussion. Newcomers are frequently shy and write you a private email. Is this a sensible question? Yes, every question is sensible, because you obviously have a problem. And I'm famous for violating the netiquette. And just, if it's only technical stuff in the mail, answer in public quoting this person. I know this is banned. No, it's not good. But most people get a warning before that I'm just doing it. And, this is some kind of training that we want to do, some open discussion. Specifically, if other people on the list have the same question, they get the answer automatically in public. Then you should write good documentation. Did I say so? Yes. Point newcomers to this documentation, because they will not find it automatically. And establish methods to involve newcomers. This is the point of this talk, because we have this established method to get people involved. Something from our... we have a rate of one developer per year who becomes Debian developer, which means just a short introduction Debian made. We are packaging for biologists and doctors, like medical imaging and practice management, which is a very, very small usage case of Debian. This is a real niche. I think if the project Debian made would not be in Debian, it's, nobody would really miss it. It's nice that it's there, but nobody would really miss it. But the project exists for 12 years, and so we got 12 new developers for Debian. This is more than 1% of Debian developers. So if we could settle more of these nice projects, we have a lot of them. They are called blends. We have Debian GIS, we have Debian Astronomy, and we have Debian Science, which could be also split in Debian Math and Debian Physics. And each of these projects would get one developer per year. We could have a lot of more developers which are doing also general Debian stuff, because well, we had 12 DDs, as I said, and some DDs were before inside Debian, but 8 of these 12 Debian developers we gathered via Debian Mails extend their action inside Debian to something else. And even 2 of them, so 10 are remaining in Debian Mail team, but 2 of them went to totally different fields in Debian and writing on the policy, doing other stuff. So we are kind of sucking developers from the outer space, move them into Debian, and they are doing nice stuff. This is the idea. And we could do similar projects even more according to the same principle, which we have called blends, and which I'm close to preaching about since 2003 inside Debian conferences. So, as I said, we have a problem to get a motivation for newcomers, and so somehow we need a lever to move people in. And we have this mentoring of the month, which is where I offer my time for the education of somebody. So people want education. I trade my time for your education to have a competent developer. And there is a sponsoring of blends. This is I'm doing for the other blends, like Debian GIS, Debian Science, and so. And here I offer my sponsoring service, as you might have heard in the form above. A Debian mentor, a Debian maintainer is needed to do at least a first upload, or if somebody has not the Debian maintainer status, for any upload. So the person who is working on a package needs me as a Debian maintainer to upload it. So I provide some service. And I said I provide the service only then if you have understand the concept of the blend. And this, how to understand this is documented. We have also written some documentation. This is what I wrote myself. And we found some formalism to make some structure in the packages of these plans. I can show you quickly later if you have time. And we are doing sprints, that means face-to-face meetings, and it just creates a fruitful environment where you can meet those people which you like to work together with. So, mentoring of the month. How does it work? The mentor, me, provides some spare time to a newcomer and guides kindly to any question which might come up. I'm really enforcing to write any question, or simple it might be, write it to the mailing list in public and tag it with MOM in the subject line, so if people are bored by this they can filter it out and don't read it, but the newbies will probably read it. And the thing is, I could train your packaging with any random package. There are these Hello World examples, but Hello World is totally uninteresting. Everybody has done Hello World, but you want to package your own package. You want to see your own software inside Debian. You want to know how. And in fact, we are working very closely together. About 50% of the students which are taking part in the mentoring of the month are upstream developers. They are upstream developers of some biological medical software and would like to get it into Debian but have no idea how. And I tell them how. So the motivation is clear. they want a package in Debian, and I want to make them a proper job, and so we are quite a good team. In principle, the student is free to pick the package he is interested in, but I might take some veto because it's too complex. We had this in the past that the package was too complex for the beginner, but this is some experience I have. The goal is that the package in question is finished and uploaded after 1 month, and the student is not able to build a package, but also knows the communication channels, knows the workflow. We have some mailing lists, we have a version control system. Everything which is documented in policy should be known to the student. So this is to deal with the tools we are using. This should be this knowledge should be provided, because there are some details and some problems in specific packages, and these should be solved. The rules are responsiveness. So I want the student to respond soon if there is some new thing. I tell him, please, you have done this and this commit. I would like you to consider this and that, and he should somehow respond. The response could be, I don't understand, please explain also, but any answer. And he should confirm if he understood anything or not, and he should confirm whether he is at the status that the package builds. I enforce open communication, as I said, I avoid an etiquette and write in public. And the best thing would be if I get a daily report. Sometimes not necessary, but some students did really daily reports. I did this and this, and tried this and that. This is the most efficient way to do this. As a summary, I can say mentoring of the month. Yes?
Very good question. Yeah. Are you able to do this every month?
I have this. I will show you in the next slide how frequently I did it.
I could see the previous slide once again.
Yes.
Open communication.
This is online. This all the slides. Don't you need to write them. This mentoring of the month is work, but work is also fun, because you always learn to know new people, and it's just always interesting. So I trade my spare time for the work of the students. And I also try, or I have the hope, that people who are just reading the list and are not showing up are reading this very detailed and learn. I have the hope. And the focus is not only on the technical details, but communication channels and so on. It's not the next slide, it's this one in between. 2 years ago, in DevCon 13 in Switzerland, there was a discussion, and I had also this talk, and I not this talk, but in this same manner. And there was an idea, spontaneous, of because formerly there was a Debian woman talk, and we had very few women. And so I decided I skip the requirement that it's a Debian made package, but if the student is a woman, I would do the training in any team inside Debian. So the interesting thing was I got one response personally from a woman from Iran. This is where you know that women are very proud and very whatever. So preconditions aside, she was very, very gifted, and I had good hope that we could do any team, and we went into the OpenStack team with one team maintainer, which was totally new to me. And I had no idea about the technique and no idea about the workflow. And we fought longer than 1 month. But I do not restrict to 1 month, right? If it's the 13th of the month and it's not ready, I said, no. We continue, right? And we continued as well. But finally, it turned out it's not the right thing to begin with. And this one man, part of the team, took over and finished it. But now we are working on a Debian Made package, and she is nearly done with it. So it works. Yes. It was interesting for me because only one woman came and got one further response via Enrico. That some women said, "Oh, that is not the right time to discuss. You should not regard."
That woman was me.
Oh, this was you.
Yeah.
Oh, this is cool.
The text of the message was really somehow, at least for me as a woman, so focused on not like inclusive women, but yeah, it really sounded like a text of hunting an animal, but I'm trying to find a woman and bring her in, and so at least for me it was very not really offensive, but off-putting, that I would feel that I get run over by a steam truck if I apply to that. But of course, I don't know you, or they didn't know you then, so I just told him about my reaction to the email, because my jaw literally dropped when I read it. So it might be a good idea to have a English-speaking woman to proofread the text. To make sure that it's more digestible.
Yeah, but it's really cool that you speak up. I really like this, and I would like to sit down with you on this text to understand it better. Because on one hand, yes, I am hunting newcomers, not only women. Yes, I'm hunting. We want you, and yes, I'm a technical person and somehow not so sophisticated about wording. Please assume good intentions if you read my notes.
I didn't.
Right? This is, yes. I would really, it's good to say we sit down and try to understand to make it next time better, yeah?
Yeah, but if you have time then.
Yeah, I'm interested. That's really cool. But I said, well, on this response, I was not convinced that we would make a good team match anyway, right? But we will see. Okay, so that's really interesting, but it's there are only two responses, but luckily enough, Alba is also in the room. We had some other, not officially mentoring of the month, but both for women, but a regular one with a woman. This is even better. Actually, I do not really like to treat women special. I would like to, if they would come as full-grown developers, it's even better.
Yeah, I agree on that one.
So, it's actually also my opinion on this Debian Women project. I'm really happy that the Debian Women project exists. But I would love if there would not even a need anymore that this project exists, because we are equal. So, okay. For the results, because this answers your question, I had 4 months in 2012, 2 in 2013, 4 in 2014, and this year was quite busy, 6 up to this year. And I have some statistics. The first one was actually a really hard one and has taken half a year, but it was a really complex one. This student was connected to Upstream, and without this project we would not have this really important package. It is some basis for some hospital information system. Hospital information systems are really complex, and this is only a database which is frequently used, and without Upstream there would be no chance to package it. So this was really important. So it was finally uploaded, not after a month. And I am in the last column, you see if these people are visible after 1 year, which is important, because you could train somebody and then he vanishes. So Luis has changed the job, but he handed over this. He trained somebody else, and so he survives. Then something was nothing. We have some people which are remain active. This student is not really involved in uploading, but he cares inside Debian for Google Summer of Code, which is also good. Yeah, some people somehow are not active anymore. I took over their packages because they are doing not any work. Ian Wallace has also a quite complicated package. It is also a hospital management system. this is too hard for mentoring of the month. And he is working from time to time a little bit. Yes, I don't know if we get this it anymore. But we have also people where I really write very active. Even now, he started in May, but he is so active on our mailing list. He is, I don't know. Alba is here in the room. Malia is this mentoring of the month for women lady, and we have another package nearly finished also in July. So you see, I don't know if it's a tendency that it's becoming more, but I can definitely say that we would not have all these packages inside Debian. Some of them are leaf packages, but some of them are quite interesting ones. And I think this table is, for me, kind of a proof that it was the effort. Yeah?
If you would estimate how much time you, on average, for these people of your time.
I think this is the wrong question. The question is, how much time would it take for me to maintain all these packages myself?
True. I'm still curious.
So it takes time. Yes.
But
I do have time.
It's an investment.
I for myself have decided that the investment is worth the effort.
No, but what I mean is the mentoring part, huh? Because
I know what you mean.
In your concept, because
it is also very different. For the very first one, very complex one, it was a lot of time, and I think for this Afif, I did nearly nothing. He just asked a few questions, and I said yes. So even this is hard to answer. Maybe 5 hours per month. One or 2 hours per week. Maybe, I'm not sure. I never counted.
And I almost said you can me that it's fun.
It is fun, yeah. You learn to know different men, so you meet different people on the mailing list. Yes, it's fun. So this is the answer to the question. I think it's worth spending the time. And since there is not every month students, the workload is bearable somehow. Maybe after this talk, even people want to, even 2 or 3 people are coming 1 month. I might refuse something, but currently not. And very important. I became a Debian developer in 1998. There was not this process with all these tricky questions. I just got a phone call that I'm really Andreas Tiller, and I'm not sure if I'm so good in the documentation as the people who recently have read all the documentation in Debian, and they sometimes know things I don't know, and I learn from them. This is also quite important. And the important thing is also that we train upstream developers who are very deep in the software itself. Some software is just make install and ready, but some other software has complex install routines. And these people know them because they invented them. And so this is kind of advantage. So about 50% of the students have connections to upstream. Sponsoring of blends. Who knows what blends are? Who don't know what blends are? Who hasn't raised his finger? I learned this is cool. Yeah. Blends is very short. You build groups of interest which are packaging software of a certain field. For instance, I'm a physicist, but I'm working in a medical institute. My motivation was, what software would be needed in our institute, and how can I provide this with one fingertip? And so I invented a system which is based on meta packages, so-called meta packages. So if I'm a biologist, and I say install med-bio, and I get all medical, all biological software inside Debian with one command. And this is quite practical. So on one hand, we are adding this software to the pool, and on the other hand, we are making it available quickly. And this exists for geographical information systems, this exists for education, this exists for science in general, this exists for different topics. They are currently growing. I wished it would be grow even more, because, as I said, by this plan Debian made, we covered 1% of the Debian maintainer. We could do more in this direction. So this is blends in short. So it has a technical side, but it has also kind of team building side, because you are hunting in the right direction. You are looking where are the experts which has the same interest like me. You get meet them at conferences or wherever and talk to them. And this is kind of interesting to get more people. So in this blends effort. There is some technical stuff around. In principle, you create a list of packages which belong to a certain topic. Yeah, the topic might be, for instance, to not stick also always to this Debian-made stuff. If you have in a geographical information system, you have an OpenStreetMap task. So if you want to have OpenStreetMap software, install GIS-OSM, and then you have everything. And if somebody comes to me and say, I have written or I have a package which is relevant for OpenStreetMap, I say, yes, I will sponsor it, but you need to make sure that it is listed in this OpenStreetMap task, and people will see what you have done. Otherwise, the Debian package pool has 30,000 even more packages. You will not find it if it's just in the pool. But you will find it, and you will find it on websites which are rendered, which I can show in the end. And for me, I try to kill two birds with one stone. On the one hand, the sponsee gets a package sponsored, and on the other hand, he has understood the blend principle and will raise his hand the next time at the right moment. Yes, I know what blends are, and I have understood the principle, and maybe I create one myself. When I had the last talk at the last DevConf, one long-standing Debian developer raised his hand and said, well, this blend concept, that's cool. You should run around and tell people, did you create a blend, a new blend today? And I said, well, this is what I'm doing since 10 years. And some people think, well, this is stuff with meta packages and whatever. Okay, it's a little bit more. So the sponsoring of blends rules, the sponsee had to confirm that he has understood the blends concept and have read the documentation. The package should be maintained in the version control system of the blends team, usually Git these days. We also allow SVN. And the package is just listed on the web page where all these packages are assembled, and he should also have tried to find the sponsor in the team, because we have teams and these people should integrate the person. If he not is able to find the sponsor, I will do it, and I will show you later some proofs how good it works, for instance in the Debian GIS team. Debian GIS team, wait a minute, I'll show you some graph before. Was started in 2004. People were so active that it goes into legend, sorry for this. And then the activity dropped because people found other stuff to do. And in 2013, I started the sponsoring of blends. Accidentally, at the same time, Sebastian Kohenberg started working and needed a sponsor. He was no Debian maintainer, no Debian developer. And I sponsored for him lots of packages. And he really was able to take over the activity in this team because I just helped him a bit, some kind of kickstarting. I did nothing more than just sponsoring his packages and a little bit answering his mails. And this is, I go back a little bit. I'm just watching a wiki page. This is organized on wiki page, and try to be fast. This is important, fast when you come a request. I read my mail, not every time, but if I read the mail and see some requests for sponsoring, I'm doing it quickly. And I'm also lurking on mailing lists like Debian GIS and Debian Science and Debian Mentors. If people are seeking for sponsoring, and I see, well, this package could fit into some certain field, I say, would you like to consider sponsoring of Blend?
Hey, what are Blends?
And then I point to the documentation and that this is a chance, and then some people do it. And some people wait and find no sponsor and come back to me for sponsoring. If you know somebody who might be a good candidate to sponsor a package, please feel free to redirect them to me. So as I showed you, this is a this is basically the discussion which was done on the Debian GIS mailing list. And the discussion increases usually also with work on the packages. And this is actually the commits, the technical commits to the version control system. And you see Sebastian Kohnberg has overrun the main drive of the Debian GIS in three years. And this was also the guy where I said I have sponsored 50 packages, and this guy was not sure if he's good enough to become a Debian maintainer. So I need to push him. You have a question?
Yes. The Fortran sounds very Dutch.
Yes, it's Dutch. Yeah.
Johan van der Wee.
He's also Dutch. Johan van der Wau.
Wau. Wau. Wau.
Yeah. Okay. This is the second person I'm also sponsored. There are currently three persons in Debian GIS which all went in for this sponsoring of Blend, because they now can be sure that their packages are done. And meanwhile, Sebastian Kohnberg is Debian developer and is sponsoring these people.
Nice.
So my work is delegated. Also in this sense, it was worth to spend the time, because now I'm out, but the team works again.
Yeah.
It was non-functional before. So the third thing are face-to-face meetings, which we are doing in the Debian Mail team since 2011. And yes, what should I say? We have, I'm in the good situation where I was driving the Debian Mail team in the first place. Somebody else in the team wrote the documentation, and somebody else is caring for the sprints and organizing it. We have Stefan Möller, who is, I could say, a bit lazy with packaging. I think he would not be in contrast with this, but he cares for new people. He also cares for Olivier, and Olivier is doing now a lot of more stuff than Stefan. So we have different tasks in the team. It works quite good. And so we do yearly sprints. It should be on the coastline in January, because there is cheap, and so we found two times hotels in Germany, two times in the UK, one time in France. Next year we are probably in Denmark, and we are maybe 15 to 20 people meeting one weekend, Friday to Sunday. So we're doing this since 2011. This is the number of uploaders. Obviously it's the top 10 of uploaders. And you see, not only, you can ignore that I have the highest peak. That's not important. This is important that we have a full base of people here, right? We have 10 active people. Yeah, we have one super busy one, but I'm not the only one. And we have these 10 active people since we are meeting, right? Not before. It was quite empty. This is about the discussion in the Debian Mail team, also here. Something happened here with the space since 2011. This is a discussion on the developer mailing list, also here. You see there is some more vitality of the topmost, 10 topmost posters. About bug hunting, same, right? You see that we have 10 active people, which were not there before. And this, the commits is same pattern. So meeting is, for me, that's the proof that meeting is important to have a valid team. This is what you definitely can learn. And the last is, this is this task concept we have. So Debian Mail is divided in biology development, epidemiology, imaging, also medical imaging development, physics, etc. And the strongest movement is, can be seen here, the biology. The explanation is that the biologists are meeting, and the other people are not yet convinced that it just meets. So also here it's a proof. Don't mind about this gap, we just didn't release meta packages, but we have here until 2010 is that way, and then the curve of the number of packages in this task is increasing. Also, if you look here for the development, this is the same. We have not so much for development, but the curves are speaking. Other fields like medical imaging is also quite good cover, but you don't have this kink in the curves. So meeting is really important. In summary, we should care nicely for newcomers. I just read before this the talk, 1 hour before, one of the persons we had on the meeting in Edinburgh, this is 1.5 years ago, became today Debian developer. So 1.5 years from the first meeting in our team became a Debian developer. If we would not have had this meeting there, this person would not be in Debian, definitely. Take your time to involve newcomers, and at least for me, I try to rank newcomer issues higher than my own coding. So if I'm busy fixing a bug and some newcomer has a problem, I try to solve this problem of the newcomer first. Sometimes it's really hard, but I hope that my talk was convincing enough that you think it's worth the time. And in-person meetings, yes. I have assembled some links. My talk is online. I provide the URL and there are some links. I have these team matrix graphs, which I have shown these colorful bars for several teams. It's very interesting. I generate them each month. And it's interesting to see the development of these graphs. There's a link to mentoring of months, sponsoring of plans, and the Debian Mail policy or documentation.
Just a question, what is there? How do you find the teams?
Yes, perhaps ask me. This is, would be so one.
It's recorded listing.
Yeah. How to find the teams? This is a good question. You could. What topic are you interested in?
I'm seeing several teams and I'm just wondering if you find them or if you know them.
If you have a package in mind, what you want to package? Have you something in mind?
Well, I have a team in mind that I'm involved with. Maybe the...
Yeah. We have language teams like Perl, Python, Java. This is a technical team. And the blends are more user-oriented teams or topics. And try to ask on a list and on any list you are reading, and somebody will point you either to me or so. And I have some overview about teams, I don't know everything. A web search might help, Debian and mathematics will lead you probably to the Debian science team also. It's hard to answer. There is a webpage Debian Teams, but it's not necessarily up to date. Ask me if you have a detailed question. I would like to do this or that in my analysis. So this talk is available here, where all my talks. You can also do a web search for Andreas Thiele talks, and you find this. You find the slides, probably also on the Debian website. If you have questions, please ask them now, and I can also show something.
It's more a comment than a question, just my experience as a mentoring of Linux engineers. I first wanted to do some packaging on Linux this year, and I was just first of all starting reading a bit of the information in Debian, and my first impression is a bit overwhelming because there is so much information that is very hard to find what is relevant for the new people. And then when I finally find something that it might be really interesting, or what I found some dependency was in one Andreas package, so I got in touch with him, and it was then when I found out about Debian team, and I didn't know about obviously anything and nothing about the team. So I found that it was quite good. And the other thing is, before I contact Andreas, I saw this mentoring idea of the mentoring of the month. But again, I found it overwhelming because, first of all, I didn't know anything about Debian, nothing about packaging. And then the idea of being 1 month hard job for somebody that knows nothing, it sounds a bit overwhelming. And for a while I was thinking if it was a good idea or not to take part of that, because you have to, so maybe I think it was good, it worked very well, but in my case I found that worked well because I had no job and I could dedicate full time to that. But my comment is, maybe for people who is just doing it that on the free time and has other things to do, maybe sponsoring a full month is a bit overwhelming, and maybe it should be reconsidered a bit, the idea, from my experience. I mean,
yeah,
in my
yeah.
case, it
yeah,
worked
yeah.
very well,
yeah.
and I'm very happy, I'm very glad, and I think everything went well. But at the beginning, it was pushing back a bit of this idea of hard job from a
That's interesting. Because
we still have the mentorships, right? Where the base is low, but
yeah.
I think the idea of the mentoring of the month is so nice that you
also
have
it. Nice that it worked,
of,
it worked very well for my case, but I'm just saying that in my case it was great, but my comment is, I'm not sure if for everybody works as well as for me. Because it will
yeah,
be
for
Ilo,
because you asked for the time, for Ilo it was very less work for me. These R packages are simple, yes, and she needed only some hints. I do not really remember that I did not. This mentoring of the month is not meant that you should work full time every day. So
no,
20 minutes per day is.
No. If
no?
you are new, you don't have enough with 10 minutes. With 10 minutes, you only have time to find a web page where it says
okay.
information and then read it properly
okay.
and understand it properly.
Mm-hmm.
It takes much longer time.
Yes.
Yeah.
Do you need large chunks of time?
I had a lot of time, so that's why it worked very well.
Okay.
My compliment for getting through with it, and I know getting started is difficult. My respect for your persistence, and if you could make it easier, we do. We will be writing documentation, and again, it will be overwhelming. I'm respectful for what you did, and the thing I can say to you, if it was easy, everybody could do it.
Yes, but it was sometimes, I found it a bit confusing because then I had Debian Med as a reference, the wiki, but sometimes I found different information in the mentor's site and in the Debian general information. And sometimes I wasn't sure which was the option. So, I was trying and see what was working and so on, in order to understand fully what you are meant. But
I want to add something. It's no difference from playing the guitar or learning to ski. Mm. You have to put some effort.
Of course, I'm not saying when
you start on something new, it's always overwhelming. But at the beginning, you are very motivated, very excited. Oh, I'm going to go skiing to the mountains. Mm. But then you are up in the mountain and you look down and you, wow, this is hard. Yeah. So, and you fall down and fall down again. And then if you get some support, which is what Andreas is presenting, then maybe you catch up faster than if you try to learn by yourself.
The message I would like to provide, I'm at your service for 1 month. Mm-hmm. And the message is not, you should work for 1 month.
My comment is, that's great, and to know that you have somebody who's supporting, that's the best you can have. But one, for new people, just like, I have 1 month and I have to learn everything. That may scare somebody if you don't have enough time to dedicate.
I have. Okay.
I have a question. As you mentioned that sometimes information you would find was seemed almost conflicting, so it was hard to.
Well, not conflicting, but
it definitely is.
Yeah. So I'm wondering whether, when you have been doing mentoring of the month, have you noticed any like common points where people kind of tripped or get confused? Like, are any of the problems of the people who are learning the package, are they like forwarded onwards so that documentation can be refined?
Yes, I think we need to interrupt at some point. Maybe we could cut the video and keep on discussing whatever, because I think it's important.
We can go on, there's no talk in this room, so we can keep on and keep
on. Okay, that's right. Sometimes it is hard from my point to write a good documentation. I sometimes said to the student, please, could you propose an enhancement of the documentation? Yeah, and a fifth today added something to the documentation which I was not aware of. So I have learned again something from the student because he enhanced the documentation. Kind of good trick how to do records. So it's not the one side thing. As I said, I try to be at your service. I do not want to scale. It's interesting that it's also scale 1 month. Should I say the mentoring of the week or so? It's only
you can change it to mentoring of the minute. So
yeah. I just want to lower the barriers to start. This is the thing. Because I know the barriers are high. This is what I heard always. People say it's so hard to enter Debian. And so what can I do? If you have better methods also. I also thought about guiding some people to fix bugs. We have a lot of bugs in our bug tracking system, and some of them are tagged patch. That means you in principle need to apply the patch, put it in the version control system, and tell me you are done. This is a job which is really not hard, but you also need to know the workflow we are using. And this is, we have different documentation. My job is to point you to the different places. Yeah, ask more.
Also, another question is your mentoring of the month. You're focusing mostly on new packaging, or is that just what happens?
It is original idea, but if you pick, we have in Lens a list.
I remember that I got most involved in Debian was actually to work on orphan packages.
Yeah. We have a list of packages where some work is done but not finished. You can pick any package to finalize it. Or, as I said, the new idea is work on bugs or work on. I support a newcomer with anything he wants to do. It was just an idea.
For me, it's most scary responsibility in the time flow. If I try to adopt some orphan package. You know, I don't know whether I will have a time in 2 years or something like that. I would prefer sometimes to do some upload of some packages which is outdated, and just it's outdated for 5 months, and I don't like that. But I don't want to take a responsibility like really adopt the package. Mm-hmm. Is it a help?
Yes, it is a help as well. One of the reasons why I have so high scores is that I am somehow the dustbin of lost packages. So I admit, usually updating a package is, if no real changes upstream are happening, a 10-minute job. So this is a lot of added 10-minute jobs. Sometimes it's hard. So if you do some work on a package, that's great. I would be more happy if you do some more packages, but any small contribution is worth doing it. And we will help you. And for instance, this mentoring of the month is not that I cut and say the month is over. We help anybody in the same manner. I would, if anybody would ask a question which is typical for mentoring of the month, I would answer it as well. But I just want to give a newcomer the feeling that he is welcome. This is the sense of the project.
Another answer to your question, I think, maybe that if you're that there's also a whole group of packages in Medium that are in, owned by quality assurance team. Basically, if you have a package there and you say, okay, I don't want to do the commitment for 2 years, if you really look into it and you do an update of the package and get a new version, then maybe not via Andreas, but on the mentors list, especially if you mark it with QA, there's I myself have more feeling for this kind of quality assurance than somebody that just wants to get his pet tool into Debian. And so if I find these kind of QA uploads that says, hey, indeed, I don't want to be the owner of this, but I do care for this package right now, if you mark it as such, you're also likely to see
or if we currently this GCC 5 transition is going, we have lots of libraries where you do basically need to do the same thing always over and over. And if it's done with higher speed, everybody would welcome this. It's technical, it sounds very challenging, library packaging stuff, but you need to rename at the suffix and it are basically done. And if you do this in version control system, the maintainer can check it, okay, and upload it, and then some work done, which is over in hopefully 1 or 2 months, if you have time now, or this summer, or at DevCon, or whatever you want to do.
Well, I would like to go back to the documentation stuff and ask how specific is your documentation. For Debian Mint. So I'm a bit afraid that we are duplicating work if you for good documentation and bad for error because we are just copying. You copy it from Bell and you will copy it from it. And
that's a valid point. In principle, it's only different URL locations where the version control system is. It would be great if somebody would say, well, I write a generic Blends policy, and we just add some specifics. Yeah,
is this something that would belong in the developer's reference?
Well, the developer's reference is very generic. We have some, we explain more detail how to git import -- pristin tar and so stuff. You just can copy this line and do something. It's more special. But it's actually, we copied it from Perl, adapted it all to our needs, and the Debian Gist team merged one from us in Perl, and so Debian asked to something similar needs to be written. But at the time when
we
wrote
it, I just wait for some Debian Sense stuff to be written, and then I would just really link to it.
But waiting is usually the wrong strategy, doing it. It's way faster. So,
that's
always. Yeah, we know that time is over. We're just discussing.
But then the question would be, couldn't you just now what's done for the main team converted to something else, or is there something which would prevent that?
Maybe most teams need to strip the subversion stuff from our policy because we are supporting subversion and other teams don't. I leave it because we would lose some supporters who just abuse it. Yeah, check if it fits your workflow. The thing is, I can only do one thing. I have a lot of potential tasks which should be done, and I try to pick the most urgent one. this is kind of prioritization, and I think it's a good idea to write some blends generic text snippets and put them together and maintain these snippets, which will work probably quite good. But I'm not really motivated to do it myself. Any other questions or dinner?
Dinner.
Dinner. Okay, dinner. Thank you.